business Saturday, beating Oklahoma 45-34 to advance to the national championship game. Tua Tagovailoa led the way with four touchdown passes. Heisman winner Kyler Murray accounted for over 400 total yards, but it was not enough. Alabama will now play Clemson in the title game next week. So, Shannon, what was your takeaway from Bama's win?
Alabama Invitational. It's only fitting that we represent. Mm. It proved to me what I knew to be true all along. That T.T., Tua Tagovailoa, is the best quarterback in college football. Mm. Now, you saw healthy what this young man looks like. Mm. Oh, so you see Skip Bayless? You see that? You see? Now, everybody going to talk about, ooh, Caliber and Jenny Reddy. He had over 400 yards. Mm. Okay, Alabama got the ball first. Oklahoma won the toss. They deferred. Alabama get the ball. They go down, score 7-0. They kick the ball off to Oklahoma. Caliber, the Heisman Trophy. Skip Bayless told me he had the best quarterback season in college football history.
He did. Look it up.
Okay. What do you do, Skip?
Can I go now?
No.
Let me go. Okay. I need to go. Hurry.
14-0, Jenny. Uh-huh. They kick back off to Kyler Murray.
Yeah.
3-and-out. 21-0. 28-0. So, in other words, all that 300 yards passing, 100 yards rushing came after the game was already decided. Mm-hmm. Everything was over but the shouting. Mm-hmm. All we needed was the minister to give the benediction.
Mm. Mm, you finished?
Amen.
Benediction. Amen to your argument, and I'm about to blow it up. So, I can't tell you how wrong you are about everything you just said, because what Saturday night proved is just how much Kyler Murray deserved to win the Heisman Trophy. I told you, OU's pass defense especially ranked 129th out of 130 schools. It is pathetically bad. It's the worst great team defense in the history of college football. And I told you, if Nick Saban allows Tua to throw the football, he can name the score. He can score 60 or 70 or whatever he wants to. And what happened right away? He let Tua throw it early. And they went boom, 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 boom to 28-0 early in the second quarter. And what was Tua in those first four drives? 9 of 9 yeah. with two touchdown passes.
What was Kyler Murray?
And then guess what? Guess what your man Saint Nick did? He started taking the air out of the football. He started to say, let's just run the football so we can keep Kyler Murray on the sideline. And all of a sudden, I'm tweeting like mad. Run, Nick, run. Please run, because it's the only hope I got. Because you're right. Kyler got off to a slow start. Why was that?
I don't know why.
Because Alabama's defense was ranked 4th in the country and came out with fire in its eyes, as I predicted, because they thought Kyler stole, quote unquote, the Heisman from their guy, Tua. So they wanted to get even. And what happened as the game wore on? Kyler Murray flat out wore out that pass rush. I'm looking at Quinnen Williams. He's just dragging. He's waving to the sidelines. He needs help because you cannot contain Kyler Murray. And Kyler Murray did something to us. St. Nick defense no one had ever done. He threw for 300-plus, and he ran for 100-plus. No one had ever done that to St. Nick.
And what did he do?
Yeah, and guess what my coach did? My coach, Lincoln Riley, hot NFL coaching candidate. How can you win the pregame coin toss and defer? Do you think you have the Salmon brothers and Brian Bosworth on defense? You can't defer. You're just saying, here, you guys go score on me, right?
Okay, well, okay. I get all okay. that.
And twice, Mike, we got 4th and 5 and 4th and 6 down deep in your territory, and Lincoln Riley took the ball out of Kyler Murray's hands. Let the kid compete for the championship. Let him try, because you take 2 field goals there in a shootout, you're not going to catch them kicking little chip shot
field goals.
I get all of that. Yeah, all of that.
But didn't I say that Oklahoma was going to win by 10 points?
Mm.
They won by 11.
Yeah, and I wanted to bet you, and I said, I'm not going to do, I said 10 points, and I would have won yet another case that I do. You would have lost by 1 point.
Stop it. Well, no, you wanted 15.
No, at the end, I said 10. I'll take, you know, I said, if I didn't have to bet against my team, I'll take the 10 points.
But I get it. Oklahoma's defense wasn't very good. Yep. We knew that coming in. Mm-hmm. I just need
not you, very good. They're pathetic.
Okay, they're pathetic. But I just need you to, if Kyler Murray is who you said he is.
Oh, he was sensational.
Alabama's defense.
He was sensational.
Alabama's defense should be nothing.
Oh, do you realize Nick ran the ball 42 times and let Tua throw it only 27 times? Thank you. Thank you for keeping my team in it. Do you realize in the second half he allowed Tua to throw the ball 10 times? 10 times. I'm just like tweeting like mad. Please, Nick, run it again. We got a chance.
Because
I got a special player. And I got to tell you, Kyler Murray in pro football, he can be at least as good as in Russ you trust. At least as good as Russell
Wilson. The damage was done. I just want to know when it was 7-0, 14-0, 21-0, where was Kyler Murray?
That defense is really good.
That's Kyler Murray. He had the best season ever.
Kyler Murray did not have his best receiver, who is Hollywood Brown, who couldn't run a lick, as I told you. He couldn't. He was a decoy at best, and the two times he got balls, he dropped two balls in his hands. Whoa. You can't do that against Alabama.
No.
Yeah, come on.
What was Kyler?
Yeah, Tua. Kyler was really good.
Let me ask you a question.
Nobody who watched that game had any doubts about Kyler Murray at the end of it because he was lighting up the tide.
You tell me. Look at the ball coming out of Tua's hand, and you look at the ball coming out of Kyler Murray's hand.
Hey, Tua,
and you tell me who's more accurate.
Tua can really throw it, but Kyler can really run it. Oh, he's electric. I told you, quickest feet I've ever seen on a football field, Kyler Murray's. Quickest ever.
Running quarterbacks in the NFL don't
last long. You can have Barry Sanders, you can have anybody.
Running quarterbacks in the NFL don't last long.
But he can buy time, he can buy lanes.
Will we see more Kyler on a football field again?
Yeah, we will.
Hey, welcome back. The Herd is coming up next here on FS1. Let's head over, check in with Colin. Hey, Colin, what's on the show today?
Oh, Andy Reid, Patrick Mahomes. You're looking over there at the Patriots. New England looked really good yesterday. Dallas looked really good yesterday, but did it matter in the Steelers? That was embarrassing. The year was embarrassing. Talking about that next.
Whew. All right, Colin, thanks. Time for our final topic of the day. Saquon Barkley had over 140 total yards, added a highlight reel leap for a touchdown yesterday. He also joined an elite club by becoming only the third rookie in NFL history with at least 2,000 yards from scrimmage, joining Edgerrin James and our friend Eric Dickerson. So, Skip, how impressive was Saquon yesterday?
Not overly impressive to me. Let's start with that leap. He leapt, and he didn't need to. He had a gaping hole. I'm saying, what are you doing? You're leaping to nobody. Really?
Spectacular.
Okay, it was spectacular, but it was completely unnecessary. Oh, please, don't stop it. So he breaks away for a 67-yard run, and he has a step, and he's gone on Jeff Heath, the Cowboys safety. He's gone, and Jeff Heath ran him down from behind. Jeff Heath, a white guy, ran him down from behind. It's impossible, but it happened right before my very eyes. So if you take away the 67-yard run, that leaves him 16 for 41.
That's
a 2.6-yard average. That means that on those runs, he was going nowhere fast. But that was his MO the whole year. One splash play, one big run, and then a whole bunch of none-yard runs. Well, Skip, I don't know. He's the icing, but he can't be the cake.
We see quarterbacks pass for 300, but they have a touchdown of 80 yards. Mm. You don't say, well, if you take this 80-yard away.
This is a running back.
Exactly.
And that's his M.O. 13, one big one.
Skip, but that's what it is.
Oh.
That's what you need. 1,307 yards as a rookie. Mm. 91 catches, over 2,000 yards.
And that got you 5-11. Way to go.
That's a team. We're talking about him as an individual. So you see what you do?
I don't know what I do.
Yeah, I see.
Did it change life? Nope.
Skip.
Changed highlight life. I'll give you that.
He's everything the Giants hoped he would be and more.
Okay. He's a great kid, but I got to tell you, this didn't do a lot for me.
Why didn't it?
Yeah, and how could even the great Hall of Famer Shannon Sharpe say, you're leaping to what? You got a gaping hole. You could back in.
Did Michael Jordan stick his tongue out? What did it do?
Who cares?
Did it have him jump high?
Don't compare Saquon Barkley to Michael Jordan.
Did it have him jump high?
Like that.
Stop it.
We'll be back tomorrow morning, 9:30 Eastern. Right now, Colin's going to tell you why the Steelers are built for TV, not for the playoffs. For the record, I liked the tongue thing. You know, it works. The Herd starts right now.
I can't believe you, Jenny.